In this video, we'll be taking a look at the shading screen. This is where you can set up shading devices that can later be applied to windows and walls on the external screen. Each shading device must have its own unique title. Note that the shading is defined from the perspective of being outside of the building and facing the wall. The build-up of each shading device is broken into three components: the overhang, the left reveal, and the right reveal. Let's examine each of these in further detail. The overhang is defined by the series of input parameters you can see in this top section here. The first thing I always recommend doing is to bring up the help for these by holding down Alt and left-clicking on one of the input fields. A diagram will appear, visually explaining what each of the parameters represent. Here you see that we can define the depth of the overhang, the length of the drop, the gap from the wall, the distance above the top of the wall that the shading starts, as well as how far the shading extends beyond the left and right edges of the wall. Note that you can also enter in negative values for the drop, distance, left side and right side parameters, giving you greater flexibility in defining the shading you require. You can also set the transmission factors for both the overhang and the drop, with a value of 0 being fully opaque and a value of 1 being fully transparent, or anywhere in between. This can help model shading devices that are semi-transparent, or approximate shading where the shading device may be opaque but not fully cover the wall. Moving on, let's hold down Alt and left-click one of the input fields for the reveals to bring up the diagram for this. Reveals are essentially fins on either side of the wall or window that you are applying the shading to. The top field defines the extension beyond the top of the wall, and the bottom field defines how far up the wall that the reveal begins. Aside from the depth and the gap, negative values can also be entered here. So for example, if you enter a negative number for the bottom parameter, the shading will instead extend beyond the bottom edge of the window or wall being shaded. As with the overhang, you can also apply a transmission factor to the reveal. Finally, at the section at the bottom of the table, you can apply rotations to the overhang, drop, left reveal, and right reveal. You can enter either positive or negative angles in here, so it really does open up a lot of possibilities in what you can model. In the future, I'll create another video showcasing some of the more complex shading geometries that you can create using different combinations of the parameters we have covered here. That's all for this video. Please join me in the next one, where we'll be looking at the window screen. Bye for now.